Hi, video time. Anyways, so I'm currently streaming Splatoon 2, which you guys can find live on twitch.tv/poke, link in the description. I wanted to do a quick little tier list, just for like no reason at all. I just kind of wanted to do one. I thought it'd be fun. Anyways, so we're gonna start off with all the specials first, because this is a tier list for all the subs and specials. And I want to start off with the specials first, because I feel like, you know, we'll get those out of the way pretty quickly. The way I'm ranking these is going to be based purely off of how good they are, in my opinion. This isn't like, you know, how good they are competitive. It's just how good they are from like a casual standpoint, really. All right, but let's see. Let's have the baller. Honestly, the baller is pretty good. It's a pretty good special. Very mobile, to be honest. It's more mobile than a lot of these other specials. So for that, I feel like an A tier, because like it can be broken, so it's not that good, but it's still pretty good. Booyah Bomb, it's instant S tier. It's just instant S tier, because like the Booyah Bomb has a weakness against certain classes. The junior class, it takes like what, 50, or it takes a certain percentage more of damage. No one ever shoots the Booyah Bomb unless the entire team is just engaged on them, which kind of sucks, because it's just really annoying for them to pop to get it off. So for that, you know, it's an instant S tier. Bubble Blower, I don't know, it's really good, but like I don't see it being as good as the baller. I see it being a little less than the baller. I don't know, maybe we'll change these later on. But yeah, ink armor in any for all of these specials is really good, because it just adds like another layer to, you know, helping your teammate or helping your team, really. So for that, it's an instant S tier in my opinion. Not because I main the junior and my special, I'm able to constantly put out like 6 armors in one game. Totally not for these. I'm told there's no bias here at all. Storm's going up for an S. Okay, I'm kidding. No. Storm, honestly, in my opinion, probably B. Because it's really good for pushing and anything, but like it doesn't put out enough ink, in my opinion. But I don't know, I feel like it's as good as a Bubble Blower. Like, great coverage, yeah, in a small area, but overall I feel like it could be a bit better. Inkjet, I'm just gonna put it out there, is as good as the baller. Inkjet takes a bit more skill I feel like Inkjet is probably one of the higher skill specials in the game. But like, it's just a really great special to use. Unfortunately, you can't get sniped and you can get shot down. So that is kind of where, like, why I class it with the baller, because he's just in that range. And that same reason, honestly, is why I would put Splashdown in A. I don't know. Splashdown's weird. In recent patches, the Splashdown has been buffed. But like, despite its buff, people still know how to kick your ass in it. So they, like, if they see you splash down in the middle of a map, you're just gonna die instantly. Especially if like you're playing with higher skilled people, you're just gonna die. But I don't know, I don't know, because if you don't use it properly, I feel like, I don't know, probably a B then. Probably a B. Bomb Rush, as great as it is. Okay, so Bomb Rush in general is pretty good for covering area, but like, I never see anybody use it. I feel like it'd be go in like a C tier, honestly. Stingray, honestly, instant A. It's an instant A tier. Like, it's a great special and it can kill really nicely, but the only problem is that you're standing still. You know, great controls, honestly, great controls. But like, the fact that you gotta stand still when doing that leaves you kind of open unless you're far in the back. But I mean, pretty good weapon though. Let's see, 10 of missiles are next, and honestly, S tier. The fact that you can beam an entire team with this if they're too close, and the fact that special power up only enlarges the reticle, like, because you with 10 missiles you have a limited space. Special power up, what it does is that it increases that space, so you have a larger area to target your enemies and shoot them from. So like, it's a pretty great special, especially nowadays right now, because at the moment, NCP89, I think it is, NCP89 and the Kensa Splatter Shot are really great because they can just get 10 missiles constantly. Like, weapons that are able to get 10 missiles now, I feel like are favored at the moment, as opposed to other ones like Ink Armor and whatnot. I feel like it's a bit favored to have 10 missiles on your team. Stamp, okay, Stamp, honestly, pretty great. It leaves you pretty open. So for me, I put it in a B tier. Yeah, so moving on to the subs now. We have the auto bomb. Honestly, it's pretty good. It's pretty good, especially if your teammate isn't expecting it. This little kitty bomb thing, it's not that bad, actually. My friends hate using it, but nothing much. Oh, okay. Yeah, my friends hate using this sub specifically because they feel like it's not as good as the other ones. And to be fair, it kind of isn't as good as the other ones. But like, if you can throw an auto bomb at someone, make them forget about it, and then just force them into it, it's so good. And like, I get pretty consistent kills with it, so like, I would feel like it's a pretty good B. You know, very hit or miss, but very easy to use. Burst bomb, okay, honestly, there's no introduction needed. It's just a great area for coverage and stuff. Instant A, in my opinion. Curling bomb, great for movement, but like, other than that, it's not that great, so probably a B. Fizz bomb, I don't know. It's a weird sub. I don't ever use it, and when I do, I hardly ever do. But fizz bomb, it's not that bad. I mean, I feel like it's just a better version of a curling bomb, though. Ink mines. If this was a Splatoon 1 ink mine, I would have said instant D tier because of how kind of, well, not maybe C tier because like you can actually kill in that game. But like, I feel like this game, it's great. It's great for the detection. But like, other than that, it's pretty good. But it does the same job as point sensor. Does the same job. God. It does the same job as point sensor, in my opinion. Because like, this is honestly equal to like burst bomb, but like, I don't know. It does the same job as ink mine. Splash wall. Splash wall is pretty good. Splash wall is pretty good. It sucks if you stand inside of it and someone throws a bomb at you, because then you're just dead. That kind of sucks. But I don't know. And then, honestly, S tier. Maybe not, actually. Hang on. Thinking about it more, because people can't really avoid this as much as they avoided that. Yeah, we're going to move those around. Because, like, I don't know. Splat Bomb is a pretty good sub, but, like, it doesn't explode as quickly as a Burst Bomb does. Okay, Sprinkler, I'm just going to be honest. B tier. Beacons, they're not bad. They're really good for like moving on the map, you know, helping your team. So probably an A tier. Suction bomb, C. I don't have to explain myself for that one. Suction bombs, unless you're a 1,000 IQ player, it's not that good. It's just not that good. It's just not really not that good. Torpedo, I don't know. I feel like it's like the same level as auto bomb, where the auto, like, you kind of have to make your enemy forget about it and focus on you as opposed to the sub. But like, you can, this one, you can destroy it. So I feel like a C tier. And then disruptor D. Honestly, disruptor deserves to be in D tier. Just because like, you can move out of it unless, like, most players have speed buffs on. And even then, you're pretty fast while swimming. Disruptor just doesn't do anything. It just really doesn't. I guess Fizzy should be up with Splat Bomb though, because like, it is a better curling bomb in my opinion, but like, I think it actually goes a bit farther, and you can change how far it goes just by looking at it, or like looking up and down, you know? So honestly, way better of like, yeah. Yeah, because like with curling bomb, you change how far it goes based on how long you charge it. And like, it's not the case. I feel like I always get the timing wrong with that one, no matter what. So, I don't know, but that's my tier list though, for that. So I'm just gonna leave that there, and we're gonna move back into Splatoon, because these are just a small segment that I wanted to do. Kato.